So we move on down for opportunities to citizens to speak to the council. And just please remember, you have 3 minutes. Okay. State your name and where you're from.
My name's Chris Nelson. I own property 8775 County Road 73, Montevallo, Alabama. I visited the council twice last year in October and November to bring to your attention the issue surrounding the governor's plans to build 3 mega prisons in Alabama, one of which will be slated for Briarfield. I've been submitting public records requests to various cities and municipalities, and I also put one in with the Montevallo Waterworks and Sewer Board. And I received a document, I think it was attached to the November minutes from that board, that the manager, Michael Harmon, had drafted a letter to the Alabama Department of Corrections and BL Harbor Construction, indicating that the water board was willing to provide water and sewer service for the construction and operation of the proposed economic development project, which I read to be the Briarfield Mega Prison. So I wanted to bring that to the attention of the council tonight to see if you were aware of it. And I know there are a few members on the board who also serve on the water board. So I wanted to ask your opinion of it. I have a printout here, which I'll hand out shortly. But to that end, I want to ask Mayor Nix, given the lack of transparency surrounding the scheme, can you explain how entering into an agreement to facilitate the mega prison construction and or operation is in the best interest of Montevallo citizens, resources, and the surrounding environment, not to mention that of your neighbors in unincorporated Briarfield? In October 2020, at the meeting, I believe you had stated that the city had not been involved with private or state entities regarding the project. And I wanted to ask if that was still the case. And then to Councilwomen Mitchell and Swords, as sitting members of the Montevallo Waterworks and Sewer Board, you accepted that appointment to represent the best interests of the citizens of your districts and the city at large. Given the lack of information available, do you support the proposal to provide utility service to the mega prison? And if so, have you made contact with any of your constituents to determine if they share your opinion? And if not, I'd welcome you to join me in canvassing your districts to make them aware of the gravity of the situation. And then to the city council, the mayor, and the leadership of Montevallo in general, I'd ask, on the same day that the will serve request letter was drafted, the United States Department of Justice filed a lawsuit against the Alabama Department of Corrections with significant evidence that the state of Alabama is deliberately indifferent to the serious and systemic constitutional problems present in Alabama's prisons for men. Can you explain how supporting an organization that has historically exhibited no desire for reform by allowing the construction of a mega prison a short distance away from your city and accepting the burdens that come with it is in the best interest of Montevallo or the state? So I have some documentation here. First page of my comments, that's followed up by a copy of the letter from the water board, a map of the proposed prison site, which as we know, and there's also a copy there of the lawsuit the Department of Justice has filed against the Department of Corrections. We haven't seen before. That's all I have. If you have any questions for me, I'll stick around after the meeting. I appreciate it.
I'm trying to figure out how to cut this thing off. And to answer your question, I still have not been contacted by anyone from the state of Alabama on the prison. I get information just like you do. The water board is a separate entity of the city, and they operate as the board. And the members of the council that are on the water board, they represent the water board too on that.
Mayor, one other thing too is, and council was provided with a copy of this letter prior to tonight's meeting from my office and from Michael Harmon's office. And first off, Mr. Nelson, no one has signed an agreement with the Alabama Department of Corrections. If you look at it, it does say that we agree to, but however, a project of this magnitude is in the millions of dollars and requires significant engineering. So merely stating that we are capable of providing water to this facility does not mean that we are going to, nor have we signed an agreement to do so. I understand that. And if you read Mr. Harmon's letter, you'll see that he also placed that burden on the developer to do so, and not on the city and not on the water board. So making a statement that we've agreed to do this is not accurate. But somebody has to bring that up. You know, I mean, there's this logistically, there is a lot more to this than just agreeing that we're going to supply water there. So I just want to clarify that, because it's been brought out all across social media and everything else that we're going to do this and it's a done deal, and that's not the case. Well, they have to have, Chris, they have to have a certain amount of privacy in discussing matters when finances are done. But you, as you know, you were given a copy of this letter because you asked for it. And that's what the way the public meeting rules. Nobody's trying to hide anything. It's a matter of public record.
Next, anybody else like to address the council?
Bobby JCP Pierson, 1131 South Oak Street. Mr. Mayor, I may be out of order, and if I am, someone please let me know. But talking about this, these prisons and all that, I heard on the news a week or so ago that these people who was talking about building these prisons have pulled out, because I'm from Elmore County down in Wetumpka, and right now the people who was going to build those prisons, it's a moot point now. Now, some other company may come back and decide to build the prison. And if that's so, we wasting time talking about spilled milk. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Can we comment?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Oh, there were three proposed sites, correct? Two proceeded, and then Briarfield kind of fell moot. Is that, am I wrong? Okay, I just hadn't heard anything else about it.
All right, go ahead. For other business, we've come to the part now for citizens' participation. You have 3 minutes to address the council.
Mr. Bay, I wanted to respond to young man from a city council leadership point of view. My voice is the voice for the people. And I know whether, I promise you, with the responses that we got with text messages and emails, you could get a good idea of how the citizens of Montevallo stand when it comes to this event. So that's where we stand, you know. And right now, it's just like he said, we haven't got any official document, any question or anything. Actually, you know more about it than I do when it comes from that standpoint. So I just wanted to let you know that, you know, the majority of the council, and I'm speaking for myself, but I know that right now we're standing with what the people would say with this particular situation. And I
had 5 phone calls and I had 18 emails. Everyone is opposed to it.
And I've had several as well, saying they was concerned about the safety of the city of Montevallo, as well as the University of Montevallo. And all of the ones that I received, probably about 20 emails, was opposing it.
All right, anyone else like to address the council? There being none, call for a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Got a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye. Thank you, sir.
Adjourn.
Okay, see you later.